Before the version 13 update, we can make custom brushes using the brush patterns available in ibisPaint X by default. We could customize the settings of the brush to our liking, but now we have a feature to create our own brush patterns. If you update your ibisPaint X to version 13 and tap on the plus, you'll just have to scroll to the bottom to find brush pattern. We'll then be greeted by brush creation settings. This is where we can change the template to a brush we like. Our custom brush will adopt the settings of the one we select and will act like it. In the type setting, there are four options: brush pattern mono, brush pattern color, texture pattern, and blurring shape. Brush pattern mono is the one to pick if you want to be able to change the color of your brush and have it be a solid single color. Brush pattern color will retain the image's color when it is at the hex FF0000 red, but when you pick a different color, the image of the brush will change to that color. But this will only work if we enable the new option color in the brush type setting after creating the brush. Texture pattern is for the brush texture, which is like this clipped texture effect. And finally, the blurring shape. Picking this one will get you a brush with the blurring shape added. You'll have to adjust the blurring settings though. The size of the brush is the size of the brush. This will affect the quality of the brush pattern or image. Let's make a mono brush first, then we'll make the other ones. I'll pick the dip pen hard. It will open this canvas with the brush shape of the dip pen. I can now clear this shape and draw my own, and I can test this drawing as a brush in the test drawing tab. But I have this brush base from the concepts app that I want to make here. I'll import the image and then I'll have to remove the background so that it's not one big black square. We can do that by tapping on the ellipses and picking clear white, but this will only work if you have a white background in the image. So I'd recommend going to filters and adding the extract line drawing filter. Adjust the settings so that the background is fully removed and only the base remains. You can check if it worked by selecting the layer opacity, which will highlight the edges. Afterwards, exit the project and you will be flashed with this modal. Hit yes if you want the brush pattern we just made to be automatically turned into a brush. As a new canvas, we'll test out our brush here and adjust the settings as we like. As you can see, along with my custom brushes, there's also this one we created that got added here. Tap on the right arrow to go to the brush settings if you're in portrait mode. We can go to the shape tab. This is where we'll be able to choose our brush patterns, so don't worry if you forgot to hit yes earlier. The brush and type tabs are very important to get the brush to act how you like it to. For example, I like adjusting the speed to thickness 1 from the dynamic setting. And I also like to change the brush thickness and opacity for it to have a thinner or thicker thickness, higher or lower opacity at the start or end of the stroke. The jitter position can be brought up to have the brush pattern be spread around like bacteria. And finally, we got the type setting where we can adjust if we want a mono, which is a solid color pen, water, which is a mixing pen, and double, which is a pen with an outline or stroke. If we quickly create a brush pattern color and draw a colored image or import one, we can test it out to see it has the image's basis colors. But when we try to use it, it adopts our selected color. To solve this issue, we can head to the brush settings, then to type, and change it to a new option called color. This will adopt the selected color, but it will change it up a bit. And to get the exact image color, you'll have to take the hex FF0000 red color, as I mentioned earlier. And only then it will display the actual color. I can now make an eye-the-only crowd. I can also go to the Shape tab and increase the dot, which will place the brush strokes in a dotted grid. And I can make my own eye the army. Now, the texture pattern. Whatever you draw for the texture pattern, it'll turn into a tile texture. And when you draw with the brush, it'll uncover this as a clipped pattern. As for the blurring shape, this one works like a dual base brush. I'll draw this squared flower. Then when we use the brush, it'll look like this until you adjust it. Now, the adjustments for the blurring shape is in the Fade tab. The blurring degree controls how much the flower blurring pattern is shown. You can have the blurring shape appear with a fade at the start, middle, and the end of the brush. They look like bugs. Okay, my favorite setting in the blurring shape would be the jitter blurring, which applies this blotchy look. And now the biggest question, dual base? If we put a custom shape and then tap on the canvas, we can see both the brush pattern and the blurring shape. So yeah, this way it can feature two brush patterns. There's a lot of settings I didn't dive into in this video, and you can check out this older video of mine going into those settings. Bye bye!